This two-set aims at promoting a reflection on who are the education stakeholders, what structures exist for their collaboration, how they are informed and involved in the school dynamics to foster equity in learning and in achievement within the context of school's autonomy. On addressing education stakeholders, we are envisaging a variety of efforts, namely all the ones having specific interests and direct responsibilities in the education delivery process and outcomes. Therefore, the concept covers the school practitioners, the families, the students, as well all the local authorities with responsibilities in the education provision, researchers, the economic agents, media, and citizens in general, within their right to information, namely in what concerns the public schools. In the interest of all them, some questions should be asked. What they, as stakeholders, know about the school running, about students' achievement, about the leaders and their leadership roles, or on how to get information on the school organization and on the existing structures for participation. The access to school information has an uneven distribution and is frequently correlated to social issues. For example, in Portugal, such structure exists for the participation of partners in school life. The composition of that structure is called General Council, the School General Council. We have parents, we have representatives of teachers, we have other school staff, students, local authorities with responsibilities in education policies, as well as other social, economic, and cultural partners. Moreover, this governing board has very important tasks as selecting the school head, approves the school educational project and other normative schools at the local context, as well as it approves the annual budget and the accounts report. So, the rationale of our tool set. Conceptually, the issues of participation fall both within the problematic of school autonomy and the ones of stakeholders' capacitation to fully participate in school improvement policies and in respective implementation, namely in context of shared responsibility in democratic settings. This reflection seems particularly pertinent in what concerns the Portuguese context, considering that in 2 years' time there will be a revision of the instruments in use in the school external evaluation, as the second cycle of this national program will come to its end in 2016. We will have as a reference framework the importance of a reliable feedback as a key tool for improvement based on knowledge and contextualized observation, and the strengthening of the distributive social participation as a developmental and empowering process in democratic societies to promote trust in public schools and in educators. Our point of departure for this exercise on school stakeholders' involvement in the educational service at local level stems on the belief that very often, in some countries, they are privileged school service consumers, but it doesn't mean they are fully involved partners in the construction of the local educational policies and the respective implementation, which presuppose the participation in the policy-making process. In Portugal, many families are concerned essentially with the schooling needs and well-being of their own children, but do not involve in the discussion of the school educational project or in the educational model debate whenever it takes place. Teachers involve parents in the individual schooling process of their children, mainly to inform them or to complain about behavior or learning difficulties, but let them alone to solve the problems which they themselves, as professionals, are often unable to solve. To respond to individual difficulties to promote better learning and equity in achievement. Moreover, the weaker the parent's capacity in establishing an intelligent dialogue for intervention and to understand the school discourse, the weaker their children's achievement as international testing has put in evidence. We have already in Portugal some studies about this, and in the analysis of the Portuguese external evaluation reports, for instance, refer to the concern of schools in involving local communities in the social and the school life, highlighting the involvement of parents in school life as having a long tradition and constituting an important concern in public schools. Data show that parents, over other stakeholders, participate in school life in response, and this is very important, in response to school initiatives to integrate them in school life, and as target groups for information sessions on how to follow their students' path and progress. Data also show that parents participate in school life as members of different boards. The patterns of their participation vary from region to region, but always depending on each school dynamics. Okay. So we already came to the conclusion that the draft of the two-set script have to call the attention or call for the need of comparative studies on the European education policies and school performance need yet to respond to some sensitive questions. We already listed five questions. That's you can see the questions over there, but I would like to inform you about something that came up in Portugal, because we are circulating around some stakeholders of the school system in Portugal, and I already noticed that one question is missing, because one of the stakeholders reflects on this tool set and told us that they became aware, analyzing the proposal, they became aware that they really have a role that they are not really assuming. So maybe a reflection on each one's roles is very important. And they also said that they agree that they have to have more initiatives regarding the role that the system itself addresses today. So this is work in progress. So everybody is very welcome to the following discussion that is going to take place in room number 5, that in front of the exit or entrance of this room, as you want to understand it. Thank you for your attention. Thank you.